God bless you all. See you in AstroWorld.
Bro, he got Drake on the track, y'all. Okay. Hey. Bro, this album's fire. Hey, yeah, yeah. Ain't seen the best yet. Open up your eyes, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the countdown till I slide. Hey. What is going on, you guys? It is your boy JP back at again with another video. Today, you guys, we are going to be talking about the one, the only Travis Scott AstroWorld has finally dropped. And I wanted to talk about it, you guys. Is it what we expected? Is it going to be album of the year, you guys? Could it be album of the year? Who and what artists have been just as good as him, has put out other music to compete with AstroWorld? I don't know, you guys, I wanted to talk about this with you guys. Who is competing with Travis Scott? It's kind of a close race right now in 2018. We got Drake that came out with his album Scorpion, which did very, very well, but it wasn't, I don't think it lived up to the hype that it was supposed to be. It didn't live up to the hype. And one artist I really wanted to talk about as well, who is killing the game as he says it. He the king of New York. He's the king of New York. Y'all already know who I'm talking about. Your boy 6ix9ine, Trey White. Yeah, but Trey White, y'all already know. Trey White! Hey, y'all already know who it is. 6ix9ine, he's killing the game right now. Trey White, that's the moves right now. I feel like he always says it. He is the hottest artist in the game, if you like it or you don't. And for you older people, if you don't know who 6ix9ine is, he is this crazy wild music that is just off the walls. He's just really crazy in general with his music. And the reason why I feel like he's so big right now, and so many different reasons, is because this guy is a marketing genius. He is a genius. He puts himself out there in every way possible. If it's bad, good, whatever, publicity is publicity, and that's what he thinks about it. And he gets in beefs, he trolls, he's everywhere. He's doing good things in the community. He's doing everything possible for publicity in every way, and that is great marketing, you guys. And that's how 6ix9ine does it. He just does amazing marketing, and everybody wants to talk about him. But 6ix9ine, he's been putting out singles. He's 8 for 8 on the Billboard. He had his 2018 album, 6ix9ine Graduation, or whatever that was. And that album did very well. I think he has 3 or 4 of those singles on the Billboards, which is insane. And he's killing the game right now. So I feel like it's 6ix9ine, a little bit below Travis Scott, and then you have Travis Scott up here. I feel like this album is going to be the album of the year, or close to it, something like that, rap album of the year. He's killing it, so much buzz, better than Drake's album. There's still other albums to come out this year, but I feel like Travis Scott album is really good. I really liked it. He has so many great features on this album. Nav, Kid Cudi, The Weeknd, Frank Ocean, so many good, Drake, so many amazing artists. He got everybody on this thing. He got everybody, y'all. So that is why I feel like Travis Scott needs to be up there in this conversation, which he is. He's all over Twitter right now. He's trending. He's everywhere, guys. Shout out to the Astros, Houston, Rockets, Houston in general, Texas. Y'all already know what it is. We in Texas. We show love to Texas, too. We out here in San Antonio. San Antonio, y'all already know I got my stuff on the walls. But we out here in San Antonio, but we still mess with Houston. They're like our brothers, sisters type of thing. But we love Houston. We love the culture of Texas vibes. If y'all don't know what it is, it's Texas vibes. Shout out to Travis Scott for putting Houston on, you guys. He's putting Houston on big time. He tweeted that this album was for Houston, this and that, and I love that, you guys. But yeah, you guys, I wanted to make this quick video on artists that are up in the game right now. Music is popping. This is a perfect time for music right now in the summer. All the albums are dropping. Mac Miller dropped his album too. Mac Miller does not get enough love. I love Mac Miller as an artist. He's not the hype artist you want, but lyrically, like a lyrical artist, Mac Miller is an amazing lyrical artist. Go listen to his album, Swimming. He's out this video real quick for you guys. I've been slacking a little bit, but I had to make this video for you guys. I got another video coming out tomorrow. Gonna do the reaction to In My Feelings, Drake. That should be dropping tomorrow. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you guys are not subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Hit the bell so you know when I drop my next video, because YouTube doesn't always get it out like that. But make sure to hit that bell. Make sure to smash that like button if you guys did enjoy this video. And if you did enjoy AstroWorld, because this album is going insane. I feel like it is going to be probably album of the year. Don't quote me on that, but I'm just saying it right now so I can go back and say, hey, I said it. But yeah, Travis Scott, AstroWorld, we've been waiting for it. He finally dropped it. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I do got more content coming. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace. Comment what y'all thought of the album. Glory always goes to God. We're out here. Peace. Like I said, shout out to Houston. We do love H-Town. Y'all already know, got the Houston Astros hat right here. Shout out to y'all though. How's y'all's day going? Let me know right now. If you guys aren't following me on Instagram, go follow me on Instagram, guys. I stay lit. I be posting a lot on my Snapchat, all that. I got a lit vlog coming. I'm gonna vlog for you guys. I haven't vlogged, but I want you guys to let get to know me better. Y'all already know. I got a lit vlog coming. Y'all can meet some of my friends, all that stuff. It's coming though. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Twitter too. My Twitter is dead. I'm getting no Twitter love. Before I go, I wanted to show y'all something else too. I got all these basketball cards. I used to collect them. And you guys, I got a lot. Look, I got the Spurs, because that's my favorite team. Red Popovich. I even got Popovich's card. Like, that's rare right there. I got all the Spurs. Rosho Nesterovic used to be the center. Robert Horry, Avery Johnson, Fabrizio Alberto, Malik Rose, Vinny Donegro, Antonio Daniels. I have all the Spurs pretty much. Like anybody could think of. George Gervin, Nazi Muhammad, Michael Finley, Steve Kerr. Shout out to Steve Kerr. I got all of them though. I got everybody. I got a lot of cards. I have some rare cards. Look, I got a Chris Paul rookie card. I have a Michael Jordan and LeBron James collab card. Ron Artest. I also have a Kobe Bryant jersey card, number 8. It's not even number 24. It's a number 8 jersey card. That thing is rare too. Look, Michael Jordan. Got a Michael Jordan card. This is like when I was a kid. All these cards are for like 2005. I'm gonna stop showing all that, and then if y'all wanna see that in another video, comment that in the comments. I don't even know what I'm doing at this point, but whatever. Dude, I just shaved. Should I grow my beard though? I just shaved. Every time I shave, I look like I'm 12. I'm like 21 and I look like I'm 12 right now. But, game. Okay.